Alright, sorry, that was a whole lot of not exciting, fun things to do while I got everything initially set up. This is my first time here, so I'm a little bit unsure what I'm doing. And I should step away for a minute because I am out of water. That was gallon jug right here. It's complete. Oh, there we go. Got something right here. Shake the camera a little bit. So I got peeing in a jar. I'm not sure if there's a huge audio or video delay. I may be running too much for this right now. Just kind of taking advantage of all the cameras that I own as an IT guy. So I have moved my painting station around for this. So things are actually a lot more, you know, they're weird for me. I'm used to having my paints on my left, and now they're on my right. The upside is I could give you guys a palette cam, which looks like I probably need to get a new piece of paper in. So, let's fold this all up. Slimy under there. My last sheet of clean palette paper. I don't know how many of you watching actually paint miniatures versus painting anything at all, really, but these stay-up palettes are really cool, except for when you're doing miniature stuff, you want a lot wetter paint than if you were painting on a palette, and so you use parchment paper instead of the paper that comes with it. This stuff likes to curl up a whole lot. Alright, let's get to it. So as you can see right now, I'm working on this Warmachine galleon for a friend. Right now what I'm working on is like this boiler up top and all of the rusty areas. Super duper exciting. I'll be using a technique that I learned from a guy named Seth Amsden. Let's see if I can move my camera. Sorry about the shakiness, folks. I've got it on a it's actually on a microphone stand with a shock mount, because that's all I have that has a camera. Screw all these words that I knew before I started this have now left me. Anyway, so I'm doing this technique that I learned from a guy named Seth Amsden, where it's kind of wet on wet, but it's more like wet on actual water. So Seth is was primarily a watercolor painter before he got into miniatures. And so what he likes to do is he likes to fully wet the area that he's working in and apply undiluted paint to it. I'm not that brave, but I will apply slightly diluted paint to it. And then he massages it in with a clean brush, which I'd like to say I'm going to do. So right now I'm mixing up this Panzer Aces. Let's see that. Panzer Aces light rust color. There we go. Panzer. Oh, go on my on camera. I don't use it very often. It's a shame. So it has kind of settled. And I don't believe I have any spare there we go. Some sinkers I can mix stuff around in. Mix it around with. Drop some fishing sinkers in there. give something to agitate it while I actually shake it. So, fishing sinker. One. And two. These are tin, I believe. Not lead, because I don't want them to rust. But that means something else in there. So, somewhere back here. I'm going to drop some airbrush thinner in there. I tend to use airbrush thinner for just about everything. And at this point, it's not even a full mix of airbrush thinner. It's like water and slow dry and a flow aid all mixed together from what I have around. Sounds like stuff's moving in there. You guys can't hear it. You hear my chair squeaking, I'm sure. Alright, let's call that good. So, light rust. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some clean water from my water that I'm filling there. I'm actually going to just wet the area I'm going to work in. As you see, I'm wetting it a whole lot. I'm trying not to stick the brush in my mouth. I get my paint, put it where I want it, in the strongest points where I want it. And then I go back with that same wet brush, and I'm actually going to massage it in. It's going to end up wrapping the paint around in weird ways. But as this is rust, I'm not super concerned about that, as rust tends to pool where liquid wants to go anyway. So let me adjust my, I don't want to see myself, I want to see you guys. Sorry to pop this out. Doesn't appear like it. But I also kind of want to see my own camera, so there we go. Alright, back to the lecture at hand. So take some clean water, put it where we want it. I'm kind of being sloppy about it, I don't really care. Take my rust. I'm just going to keep working around this. Should I move my water closer? I'm just reaching across, seeing how bad that is. That's pretty terrible for you guys. I promise I will clean up my office in a way that's useful for this. I hadn't put a whole lot of thought into what I was going to do this other than I was just going to do it tonight. And that was going to be enough for me. So yeah, here I am. First time painting on Twitch. My name is Dave Matney. I'm not a professional painter. I am a software developer by trade and a miniature painter by hobby. Somewhere along the line, someone told me that I paint decently, and I was like, you know what, I'll let people watch me paint. And so now, here I am, and you guys are here, and it's a grand old time. I'll try to keep the painting in the camera. So if you... One of my actual friends that jumped over from my Facebook link. I don't know if there are any of you on here right now, but if you're here, you probably heard me say that one of my personal pet peeves about painting is when people add rust to brass. The other precious metals that don't naturally rust. This technique that I'm doing now, that I brush on and brush on wet, massage it in, will end up with rust on the brass, but it's in a more natural way, like rust just streaming off of steel or iron and onto the brassy areas, and less like I somehow think that brass would rust given the right conditions. Fortunately for that idea, science doesn't agree. So, I plan on bringing this rust up pretty high as far as rust goes, and I'm going to knock it down with a Nuln oil by Games Workshop. I'm painting this section differently than I painted my other section, so it's reacting differently. I like what's happening, but it's a lot less predictable than painting on totally dry surfaces for both good and bad. Let's see, it's a way to make this camera focus better. I'm gonna shake you for a second, sorry. Focus way back here so we can get it's not where I want to be. It's gotta be a trick to this camera.
That's what I'm comfortable with. You guys, that's a lot better, aren't they?
So working in this rusty area, let me just get a couple of different rusts around in here as well. So we got that red rust I just pulled out. Got a black brown up in here that I'm looking for. Probably right there. Yeah, that's gonna be a model color. Going black brown. Love this black brown. But it's separated. And then I've got Galleon model air. This is a, I want to say it's a light rust. The logo has worn off. Area. Want some dark brown in there. I've been discovering this technique over things like the typhus corrosion, is it doesn't really, really like water, and these corrosion effects don't really like each other. It just keeps pulling it right off the metal paint that I laid on earlier. Down there. Cool. Which is fine. I can't expect perfect rust, and I'll go back over it with dry pigments later anyway. So let's get a nice ugly mix of colors in here. Not too concerned with precision. Actually kind of want the colors to puddle and like they're doing around these bolts here. In fact, let's add some water down in there. Seems counterintuitive in most painting, doesn't it? To add water. Just let it pull your paint around. That's what we're gonna do. Might have gone a bit too aggressive there. Water. Just let the water pull it out. Let's get up on these stacks here. Need some love. I don't know if you can tell on the camera, but I keep bumping my head into my light. Some crazy whistle happening in your sound output. Thanks, Steve. Let's see if I can change my audio source here. So this one, we want unmuted. Use something totally different. Is that any better, Steve? Still very whistly. Shit. It's probably my desktop or that is no bueno. I have to isolate that a little bit better. Which involves cleaning and moving more of my office around. So it's not unbearable, it's just not great either. Anyway, I think I'll just go back to painting. I'll deal with that later. Because nobody wants to watch a guy play the computer off screen. Actually, speaking of playing with things off screen, just making this a little bit worse. Let's utilize tools we have. Brush to get them wet. And that's going to be terribly annoying, I'm sure. Okay. You can see how messy this desk is. I'm ashamed by it. But everything's wet now. Brown up in here. Brown is there. Some red. And bright red. So you can see I'm not even applying it in any sort of intelligent way. Advantage of the wetness to keep it wet. I wasn't the person that assembled this model, so it's possible that there's a huge, like, empty hole right underneath these stacks that I'm just filling with water and paint. Do tonight is finish this up and seal it. I think that's a problem that I'm having, that it's not been sealed in a bit. So the paint is being, previous layers are coming up with the water. Which shouldn't be a thing with acrylics, but I guess I have that typhus corrosion with the crackle effect I used yesterday that nobody watched. When we get paint on this camera, and that will be awesome. Terrible that looks right now. You need to keep in mind that this is mostly for the purpose of rust runoff, and less for the purpose of rusting these particular pipes, as I'll go back in later with dry pigments and actually add rust where I really, really want it. Ah, shit, did I get that in? But this is all very, very experimental to me. I've mostly used this particular technique on landscapes, large bases, and it just runs off nicely. Wet. Okay, so you can see where I'm working. sure there are miniature painters out there right now, because they're watching this or cringing at the amount of precision I don't have. So this spot up in here has a huge amount of water. Let's see if we can take advantage of that somehow. Maybe coax it out of another spot. Just have it run on down. Gravity is our friend. Take a look at this spot right here. Let the water just pool up into it, and get a couple different textures of rust already in there. Let's get some more. I like that bright a lot, so we're gonna spot of that. Just a little bit. Maybe a little more. this area. It's the same idea. Scars here in the resin that came from factory. Need a little bit of love. I'm not sure you can hear anything actually. Let's jump over there. Am I listening? Can you hear me? Maybe. I'm working. I wonder. I have a lot of flexibility with this camera right now, so let's get it right. You guys can't see anything. A little bit better. Sucks for me, but it's better for you guys. See that? That was amazing. Back, it's a wash. let the rust happen. Some more down. Like I said, this isn't at all a precise art. The point is to not be precise. For precision, it wouldn't look totally natural. It wouldn't be totally natural. Precision's for the dry pigment. here. A lot of paint in there. Anyway, I think I'm going to call it for the night because primarily I wanted, just wanted to figure if I could get this working. It appears that I can. I just need to work on the audio issues, which I think is my computer itself being too close to my microphone. I could think of a sound, like X sound guy, but I would have had that figured out too, but nope. Not even a little bit. I need a new video card because that's my current one sounds like a helicopter. So, I have been Dave Metney. I paint slowly. At some point, I will be doing something with the name Pinhead painting. But right now, I am just painting on Twitch, because people seem to care to watch that. The two of us, I think I am counted in that. Next time I run this, I will actually do something with the dwarf bust that I've painted. So let me get that out so you can just see it. So. Oh shit. Camera. Next time, a day of paint slowly, we'll get to this guy. Still working on his armor. I need to finish it up because it's kind of getting boring. If I can get to his leather armor, and get to his face. Sorry, get to his beard. After that, I am strongly considering beating the hell out of him like I beat the hell out of our founding father Thomas Jefferson right here. So Thomas Jefferson. I've seen better days. But he's kind of a glimpse of things to come for the dwarf. And then I intend to paint a couple, finish up one of my pinheads. These pinheads, you say? Yes, the entire point of this name is for painting these Space Marine heads on pins, ideally to a higher than tabletop standard. Let's get this guy up close so you can see what I'm talking about. That's you. I have another guy around that's half finished. This guy is probably, I could call him finished. I plan on starting a new one with this guy. Super exciting. Basic bare-headed space marine with bolts in his forehead. It'll take some work to get used to painting with all this stuff in the way. Oh, here we go. Another pinhead that you can't see. He still has some metallic stuff I need to worry about. Probably edge highlight his hair. Before I can throw him up for sale. Oh, yep. Put the cat out of the bag. I plan on selling them. Painted pinheads. So, for next time, speed up the camera a little bit. This is what I've been working on. Zoom in. And you all have a good night. Now you're gonna stop this.